Really nice job in the first turns there. She skis with such power, touch, efficiency, and grace. She seems to combine them all together. It looks like her legs are cooperating. She's feeling them. They're working really well. So balanced. See how, look at the shoulders never move. The head never moves. This is what she does that's so incredible and so much better than anyone else in the world.
You talk about balance. Her mom bought her and her brother a unicycle to juggle on around the neighborhood to create that kind of balance on the ski hill. And Shiffrin's got the lead by about 2/10.
She's just working that groove perfectly with a high line, getting early edge pressure, using the groove in order to generate speed, and maintaining contact with the snow.
Final couple of gates for Shiffrin, who's across the line a half second ahead of Hupparish. Dad's pumped, mom's relieved.
And she did it with her trademark discipline of upper and lower body, those smooth, fluid movements showing her mastery. Look at the shoulders, hands, knees, all in one line, motionless, while the skis clear and loop from side to side, generating speed. That's really just perfect form. And here from behind, it looks like a Ted Ligety giant slalom turn. Her hips are gracing the snow. It's probably a couple inches off. The skis cleared well away from the body, arcing powerfully.
42 years since an American woman last won this event in the Olympics. The father awaits at the bottom. And all those runs with mom on the hill, all those hours visualizing, spent dreaming about this moment. Less than a minute away from it all maybe coming true.
Her coach, Roland Pfeiffer, says she is so young, yes, but mentally she is one of the strongest skiers on the circuit, and she needs to draw on that now, as she always does.
Coming out of the start gate, she had more than a second lead over Shield.
And she is skiing with such efficiency, such confidence, losing a little bit of time, but remember, she's got this big pad, she needs to be smart.
And Shiffrin nearly loses it right there.
Amazing recovery on one ski. That Shiffrin, so balanced. She rarely makes those kind of acrobatic recoveries. She rarely has to.
Somehow, some way, Shiffrin was able to stay on her skis at the top, and now seems like she's in absolute control to the finish. Mikaela Shiffrin wins gold for the U.S. The youngest American to win Alpine Olympic gold. This is going to take a while to sink in.
What is this?
Well, and here's how she did it. Here's how she almost lost it. She was creating such acceleration that she finally can't control the kick. The ski rebounds, and she barely pulls it back together. But does she ever? After launching into the air only a couple of gates later, she's back in full control with that smooth, solid, powerful, almost magical touch that Mikaela Shiffrin has on skis.
I almost fell over in the
go.
Good job.
In the end, it turned out okay for 18-year-old Mikaela Shiffrin. She wins gold, Shield wins silver for the second straight Olympics, and Kathrin Zettel picks up her first Olympic medal.